We start off with MTA news. New York State Governor Andrew Cuomo announced that New York will fully open MTA subway services. The 24-hour subway service will return to New York City on Monday, May the 17th. The restoration comes just after about a year after the governor ordered the system to be shut down overnight for COVID cleaning and also ordering homeless riders out of stations. The changes come as vaccination rates climb and COVID cases plummet, prompting the governor to also announce the lifting of capacity limits for most businesses beginning Wednesday, May 19th. Restaurants, museums, theaters, and retail stores, as well as other businesses, will be allowed to reopen at full capacity in just over a week in the Empire State. In other news, the council legislation looks to protect small businesses from excessive fees by inspectors as they look to reopen. Our Bronx Net reporter Arlene Makoko brings us the story right now.
Small businesses still reeling from the impact of a global pandemic have more to be concerned about, says City Councilmember Vanessa Gibson, who introduced legislation to stem the onslaught of fees by city agency inspectors that could derail a strong economic comeback.
Instead of imposing punitive fines on them, we must help to educate and provide outreach to each of our businesses, and equally important, provide the resources and the support that is necessary for them to operate their businesses.
Outside Yankee Tavern and joined by Bronx Chamber of Commerce President Lisa Soren, Executive Director of the 3rd Avenue Business Improvement District Michael Brady, and Chairman of the 161st Street Bid Dr. Carrie Goodman, Councilmember Gibson talked about the proposal that would force the city to work with owners who've demonstrated their commitment by either opening their doors during the pandemic or reopening after being shut down by working with them through non-health and safety violations.
I had a business call me yesterday. They got a $100 fee because they didn't have the DOT sticker on their window. This is a business that opened up in March of last year and was shut down immediately. How about somebody telling them that this is what's needed?
And along with that, outreach by the city on their new restaurant revitalization grant program, as the application process is set to begin shortly. Also there, Francisco Marte, who says he was threatened with closure by an inspector for not having a cooking instrument be the right weight.
He said, if you don't have an upgrade, I'm going to shut you down. That's not the way you approach. Even that day I called Vanessa's office.
That's when the inspector had a change of heart.
And then he went back, and he was so nice, and he said, oh, everything is fine. Everything is fine. You're good.
And Yankee Tavern, that opened its doors to business in 1927, last year they reopened in accordance to CDC guidelines, says current owner Joe Bastone. But that didn't come without a price.
Personally, I've gone through over $150,000 of my personal money to keep my place open. We were open the entire time, even though I was bleeding money, thousands of dollars a week, and then I'm still losing money.
This just one of the many examples that demonstrate a need for laws to protect businesses.
This legislation would provide civil penalty relief for small businesses from certain sanitation, health-related, transportation, consumer affairs, noise control, and buildings violations.
Something, if enacted, would speed along the Bronx's recovery.
It is time for us to invest in our small businesses smartly, and part of that is removing these insidious regulations, totaling over 6,000 right now in New York City, so our city's businesses can grow and we can truly be a comeback borough, a comeback city.
This bill will go a long way because it's still holding businesses accountable, right, but it's relieving a bit of the burden, and that's what we need right now.
Well, the legislation was introduced into the city council in March, and right now it's waiting for a vote from the full council. For BronxNet, this is Arlene Makoko.
And thank you, Arlene. And that's all the time we have for our Bronx updates. We encourage you to stay with us. We've got a great show here on Open coming up right after this.